Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm Erin Fehlau. We do have some breaking news from noon. All public schools in Danvers, Massachusetts were closed today while police investigate the murder of a teacher. Police announced this morning that a 14-year-old boy had been brought into custody. They are not releasing his name. They say that this investigation started after they got a call that 24-year-old Colleen Ritzer, who's a math teacher at the school, did not return home yesterday after school. That's when investigators found blood in one of the school's bathrooms and then later found her body in the woods behind the school.
I can say that she was a very, very respected, loved teacher. And at 24 years of age, as I said, it's a terrible tragedy for the entire Danvers community.
No time has been announced for the 14-year-old's first court appearance. We will bring you any new developments here at WMUR.com and also on the air starting at 5 o'clock. Well, a new search today for missing Maine toddler Ayla Reynolds. State and local police, along with game wardens, are searching a wooded area in Oakland, Maine, for any sign of this toddler who was reported missing in December of 2011. There have been several searches since she disappeared from her father's Waterville home. Police have called an afternoon press conference, and we hope to learn more information then. Well, exactly 2 weeks ago today, Abigail Hernandez vanished. This 15-year-old was last seen at Kennett High School on October 9th. But Abby's family, along with the community, are still hopeful for her safe return. A flashlight vigil and walk has been planned for Saturday evening at Schuller Park in Conway. Well, pretty soon this place is going to be packed with fans trying to get into Fenway Park for the first game of the World Series. Our Ray Brewer starts our day-long team coverage in Boston.
As you get off the tee at Kenmore Square, there's no doubt you're in Red Sox country. But in the square itself, it was more business as usual. Few signs of Go Sox. Although there were signs of support, including firefighters on a call. Outside Fenway, Sam McCasey had been camped out since Tuesday, hoping to get a ticket, a very confident Red Sox fan.
I don't think the Red Sox can lose a World Series game. They never have in my lifetime, and I don't expect them to, so another sweep.
Next to him, though, a native Cardinal fan who's predicting a Cardinal victory, although it will take longer.
I think it's going all seven games, and I don't know who the MVP is going to be.
While not Dice K fever, there is evidence that the Sox still have a following in the land of the rising sun. This family flew in from Japan hoping to get tickets.
My son likes Red Sox very much, so me too. We watch the game every time.
Bars around the area are getting ready for the crowds, but the mayor and police have put in new restrictions designed to cut down on rowdy celebrations. Police saying they will have 500 officers patrolling the area. And while these are heady times for Boston sports fans, with all four teams having won championships in the past decade, this run is something most Red Sox fans aren't taking for granted.
I remember the Steve Grogan years. I remember the, you know, Rick Burleson years. I remember all those years where it was close but no cigar. So I lived through that, and so I'm just living it up while I can.
And our live team coverage continues all day today and tomorrow from Fenway Park. And then we're sending sports director Jamie Staton and Gene Mackin to St. Louis for a live coverage as the Sox try to win their 8th World Series title. Well, starting tonight at 5, inspectors have stopped more than a dozen shipments of spices in recent weeks because of dangerous contamination. What you should know about the seasonings in your cabinet. And the government shutdown means you'll get some extra time to file your taxes, but you'll also have to wait longer to get your refund. That does it for us. Thanks for joining us and have a great afternoon.